Lesson number three, how does Tezos upgrade itself? Tezos is a blockchain designed for safety, open participation, and upgradability. Upgrades on Tezos are handled in a methodical way that allows all Tez token holders to have a say in the network's future. Other blockchains sometimes struggle with upgrades. They often lack clear processes for making improvements, causing disagreements among stakeholders and holding back innovation. In some cases, the blockchains can even fork, creating new cryptocurrencies, splitting their communities, and reducing their network effects. Tezos, however, has two features designed to help resolve these issues and incentivize innovation: a formal governance process to coordinate upgrades, and inflation funding. The formal governance process consists of four different voting periods. Each period lasts about 23 days. During these periods, the bakers vote on behalf of their own Tez tokens, as well as any that have been delegated to them. Delegators can change to a new baker at any time, too, to better align with their voting preferences. During the first period, the proposal period, any Tezos baker can submit a proposal to upgrade or amend the Tezos blockchain. Bakers can then upvote their favorite proposals. The most upvoted proposal during this time advances to the exploration vote period. In this period, if the proposal receives enough support from bakers, then it advances to the testing period. During the testing period, a temporary test chain is created to help make sure the proposed upgrade works and is safe for the network to adopt. After the testing period, the proposal advances to the promotion vote period. In this final voting period, bakers vote to determine if the proposal will be implemented. If the proposal receives enough support, then it's approved, and Tezos upgrades itself automatically with the new code. It becomes a part of the main Tezos chain. Thanks to this formal governance process, in 2019, Tezos became the first blockchain to upgrade itself automatically without requiring a fork. Even the formal governance process itself can be upgraded over time. The second Tezos feature designed to improve upgradability is inflation funding. During the governance process, bakers can propose upgrades to improve Tezos. But what incentivizes them to do so? Developing and proposing a blockchain upgrade can be a lot of work. This problem, how to pay for long-term core development and upgrades, is something that affects the blockchain industry as a whole and can lead to slower innovation. Inflation funding is designed to solve this problem. To incentivize people to create proposals, Tezos allows bakers to attach invoices to their proposals. If a proposal is successfully approved in the governance process, then the protocol automatically mints the amount of tokens specified in the invoice and pays it. This means that upgrading Tezos over the long term doesn't rely on altruism and external organizations to reward innovation. Instead, developers are financially incentivized by the network itself to improve Tezos. Together, the formal governance process and inflation funding allow Tezos to evolve openly and methodically without forks or splits in the community. And because every stakeholder can participate in this process, it's a true digital commonwealth. And it's just the start.